Father Lord, prepare my heart to receive from you this morning. Don't let me be here in vain this morning. Let me receive, let me bless your word this morning. Prepare my heart, Lord. That you remove every obstacle in my heart, Lord. Every evil thought. That Lord, prepare my heart to receive from you this morning. That's why I'm here. I want to be blessed with your word this morning. Daddy Lord, consume every spirit of buying and selling in my thought this morning. Every spirit of distraction in my life, Lord, in my heart, Lord. Daddy, consume them this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your word have been in my life this morning, Lord. Let your word transform my life, Lord. Let your word give me new beginning this morning. Let your word be a blessing to my soul this morning, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Everlasting Father, King of Glory, we worship Lord again this morning. We thank you, Lord. Because you are the Word. We thank you, Lord, for the grace given us to be your presence this morning, Lord. May thou exalt in the mighty name of Jesus. That, Lord, we are going to your Word this morning. At the entrance of your Word, there is a liberty. That, Lord, liberate us throughout this world this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. That, Lord, you are the great teacher, Lord. Both the speaker and the hearer, Lord, teach us from above in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's, Holy Spirit, interpret your Word to us this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. That, Lord, let your Word have impact in our life this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for asking our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let us be seated. Praise our living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise our mighty Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You are welcome to our service this morning. And I pray God Almighty will give you peace of mind in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God will give you the ability and the strength to follow him to the end in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
When Christ will come in his glory, you will be partaker of that glory in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why can't you hear it? Big amen.
Amen.
And you want to be part of the saints? If you want to be part of the saints, say big amen.
Amen.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The message of God this morning says, follow the Lord's rule for doing his work. Follow the Lord's rule for doing his work. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God has called every one of us as a believer, as an instrument in his house. God has given us wisdom. God has implanted something in our life. God has given us gift so that we can be a workers in his house. But being a workers in the house of the Lord, there is a rule that we need to follow. There must be rule that we need to follow as a children of the Lord to be able to do the work of God effectively. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
To do the work of God, we need to set a boundary. If you determine to be a worker, determine to serve God, there must be a boundary. What do I mean by a boundary? You need to set a boundary by yourself and the people of the world. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When you set a boundary, don't expect anyone to love you and to understand you. When you are setting a boundary for the work of the Lord, don't expect anybody around you to love you the way they loved you before. Don't expect anybody to understand you. Don't expect anybody to care for you the way they care for you before. Because there is a new boundary. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Following the Lord's rule for doing his work. Work of God is different from our own work. Work of God is different from our work, our own work, our daily work. So, by determining to do the work of God, we must set a boundary. That's number one policy. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
By setting a boundary before, we are mingled with the people of the world. We have different friends. We have different character and attitude. But when we determine, say, if you are a new Christ, you are a new born again. So when you are a Christ, you are renewed already. So when we are in Christ now, we must be renewed. Everything in us must be renewed. Praise the living Jesus. So when we determine to serve God, we must set a boundary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Am I speaking to someone this morning?
Yes, sir.
Am I speaking to someone this morning?
Yes, sir.
Being a servant of the Lord, it doesn't mean that you have to be a pastor or an evangelist or a bishop. We are all servants of the Lord. And that is why we must receive Christ as our Lord, our Savior. And as you receive Christ as your Lord and your Savior, there must be no new beginning in your life, which means you set a boundary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maybe you have time for the people of the world before. You have time to do things of yourself before. You have your friend that come dance before. You are going for partying before. You are going for clubbing before. But immediately you decided to serve God, there must be a boundary. And that is why, don't expect everybody to love you the way they loved you before. Your family will hate you. Your brother and sister will hate you. People around you love you, but they will hate you. Because of the world, because of the new boundary. That's why Jesus Christ said. He said, they will hate you because of me. Praise the name of Jesus. He said, no, they will hate me. People of the world, they will hate you because of me. So, when you decided to carry the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, people will hate you. Your mother will hate you. Your brother will hate you because they don't have the access they are having before. They don't have the privilege they are having before. The time you spent with them before, you don't have that time anymore. They will hate you. Praise the name of Jesus. And when they hate you, that's a new step for you. Because you are no more with them anymore. You have set a boundary. Say to yourself, I will set a boundary today.
I will set a boundary today.
Tell yourself, I will set a boundary today.
I will set a boundary today.
Brethren, as a worker in the house of the Lord, as a minister of the Lord, he said, we have been ordained. He said, you have been chosen as a what? As a vessel of honor. So, when God has chosen you as a vessel of honor, which means you yourself, you have to put yourself as a vessel of honor in the people's eyes. People around you, people you have been moving with. You don't need to tell them you are a born again Christian, but they are the ones you going to church. But you have changed. Maybe you are getting drunk before. Maybe you are partying before. All those things of the past, they will look at you now. Something is happening here. You don't need to tell them. You have set a boundary. Praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Following the Lord's rule for doing his work. Let's look at the Timothy we read this morning, chapter 2. Timothy chapter 2, verse 4 to 5.